Today's our topic is legal care for geriatric person. Legal issues, act of negligency, malpractice, omission. Negligency is a failure to exercise adequate care. Omission, it occurs when something omits. Malpractice, it is the negligence on the part of professional person in providing care to another person. Poverty among the adultery, illiteracy, employment, dependency, living arrangement, health problems, physical disabilities, issues of aging population. Elder abuse, according to a rough estimate, nearly 40% of old people living with their families and reportedly facing abuse of another. But only one in six cases actually comes to light. Neglect is the most common form of abuse at 48.7%, followed by emotional and psychological, financial exploitation, physical abuse, and abandonment, respectively. There is a growing number of insecurity, injustice, and abuse in elderly in India. Dementia and Alzheimer, according to National Dementia Report 2010, approximately 2.6% to 3% people over 60 years of age suffer from some form of dementia. United Nations, in 1991, the General Assembly adopted the United Nations Principle for Older Persons, enumerating in 18 entitlements for older persons relating to independence, participation, care, self-fulfillment, and dignity. The following year, the International Conference on the Aging met. The International Conference on Aging met to follow the plan of action, adopting a proclamation on aging. MIPW was adopted at the United Nations Madrid International Plan of Action on Aging 2002, MIPAA. Subsequently, the General Assembly endorsed the plan on December 2002 during its 57th session. The Second World Assembly on Aging brought together delegates from more than 160 governments. Human rights of senior citizens and advocate standard of living, including adequate food, shelter, and clothing, advocate social security assistance and protection, freedom from discrimination based on age or any other status in all aspects of life, including employment and access to housing, healthcare, and social services. The highest possible standard of health, dignity, protection from neglect, and all types of physical or mental abuse. Full and effective participant in decision making concerning their well-being. Indian Constitution well-being or older person has been mandated in the Constitution of India, Article 51. A directive principle of state policy has directed that state within the limits of its economic capacity and development make effective provision for securing the right of public assistance in case of old age. There are other provisions which direct the state of improve the quality of life of its citizens. Right equally has been guaranteed by the Constitution as a fundamental right. These provisions apply equally to older persons. Social security has been made to concurrent responsibility of the central and state governments. National Policy of the Older Person, NOP, NPOP, 1999. The Indian government, after many years of debate, finally declared the nation policy of the older person in January 1999, the International Year of the Older Person. The policy highlights the rising elderly population and an urgent need to understand and deal with the medical, psychological, and socio-economic problems faced by the elderly. However, what the policy did emphasize was on the dominant role the non-government organization to play the assist to government in bringing forth the society where the needs and the priorities of the elderly when taken into account, it recognized the older person as a resource of the country. The national policy statement includes the following: ensuring the well-being of the elderly so that they don't become marginalized, unprotected, or ignored. Protection on various fronts like financial security, health care, shelter, and welfare, including protection against abuse and exploitation. Ensuring for the elderly an equitable share in the benefits of development, as well as addressing the neglect or elderly violence on three counts: widowhood and gender or age. Promoting an age integrated society by adopting mechanisms for improving intergenerational ties. Considering the elderly as a resource by advocating their inclusion within the family, community, and society. Viewing the elderly as an agency which needs to be empowered with regard to their voice and representation. NPOP, saline feature of the NPOP. Financial security, healthcare and nutrition, education, welfare, protection of life and property, shelter, basic facilities, NGOs, research and training. Thank you.